This video is about basic statistics in MATLAB. We're going to cover mean, median, standard deviation, variance, and also correlation. Now, to calculate mean in MATLAB, we just need to use the mean function. So to calculate mean first, we have to load a sample data set in MATLAB to run the statistical analysis. So one data set that we can use is the WIN data set. So I'm going to load WIN first. By typing load win, it loads up the variables of the win dataset. As you can see, it's made up of 35 rows with 41 columns, and there's 15 different matrices within the U variable. So for me to access the first matrix of this U or V or W variable, I just need to set the last number of the index of the matrix. So for example, all of the variables in the first in the rows, then colon, which means all of the columns in the matrix, and 1 means the first matrix of this multi-dimensional matrix, because there's 15 of them here, and then we don't need to use all of them, we just need to use one of them. So if I press enter, it'll just display all of the values of the first matrix of this U variable. It's a large list because there's 35 by 41 elements. So now since we have the data loaded up, then we can use those statistical functions like mean, median, and so on these variables to show you how to use them. So the first one we're going to use is the mean function, which calculates the average of values. So I can just calculate the mean of U, and then I'm going to use the first matrix of this U variable. Close parenthesis, press enter, and then it calculates all of the columns of the matrix U. So this is the average of the values of all the rows in the first column up to the 41st column. And the same goes for median. You just need to use the function median and then the variable, and then specify that you'd like MATLAB to calculate the median of the first matrix of the U variable, and then it will display the same results. Now, what if you like to calculate the mean or median of the rows instead of the columns? Then you just need to type in mean U. The second argument of this mean function is the number 2 to tell MATLAB that you like it to calculate row-wise. There, it gives all of the mean values of every row for the first matrix of the variable U. The same goes for median, U, 1, 2, and this is the median of all of the rows of the variable U. To calculate standard deviation, you just need to use the function std. It works the same way as mean and median. This is the standard deviation of all of the columns in the variable U. But if you like to calculate the standard deviation row-wise, then you just need to type the same thing. Second argument is the normalization factor. So since we're not interested in normalizing the data, so we just use the value 0 to show no normalization to be done on the values. And the third argument should be 2 to tell MATLAB that you're interested in it to calculate the standard deviation of every row. Oops. For variance, you just need to use the function var. Now let's look into how do we perform correlation in MATLAB. to perform correlation, we use the core coif function. And how we use that is by first expecting that the results of the correlation analysis is two values. One is the correlation coefficient, and the second is the p-value. So to extract two values from the function, then we need to say that we are expecting two values. We're going to name it as capital R and P. And then the function itself, core coif, and the two variables that we would like to find the correlation of. So the first one, let's say U, that's the first column and the first matrix, against, say, V. And it displays the correlation between the two. So one here is the correlation between U and U, so that's why it's one, and here is between V and V. But this is the actual correlation between U and V. We see here that it's a negative correlation between U and V, and these values here is a mirror. This value here is a mirror of this value. Now the P is the p-value. In this case, the p-value between U and V is 0.06. So let's take a look at the data. We can view the data by using the plot function. U against V. I'm going to color it black. Oh, it's a line. So let me just change it to a marker X. And then put it side by side so we could see the output straight away after typing the command. So that is the relationship between V and U. Let me add the label. No, the x-axis is U, and the y-axis is V. Then let's plot the line that goes through this data. We can do that by typing in the function lsLine. And you see that it's a negative slope, and that's why the negative correlation that we got from the results of the correlation. Now let's look into how do we create box plots in MATLAB. We can create box plots in MATLAB by using the boxplot function. We're going to use the u variable here. As an example, to plot, just type boxplot, and then the variable. Because there is 41 columns in the U variable, MATLAB produces box plots for each one of those columns. If you like to see individual columns, then you just type in one. The column 1, and you see for the column 1 box plot. This line here at the bottom of the box plot is the lower quartile. This red line here is the median, and this line here is the upper quartile. The whiskers here and here show the extent of the rest of the data. If there is an outlier, then it will be outside of the whisker range. Okay, so that is it for this video. If you find it useful to start using MATLAB for statistical analysis, then consider giving a like. If you have any questions, then you can write in the comment section below. And I will see you in the next one.